Hello children, welcome back to social class. In the last class we already started a new lesson, that is industries of Karnataka. In that we already learned about an introductory matter, then types of industries and a group of industries, where and all it was started, and also even we started about various other industries, even as about it was established in the Karnataka. Among that we already completed about two. That is, one is the cotton textile industry, another one is the, that is the honesty industry. Now let's go for the remaining industries in the today's class. First let's go for that sugar industry. Sugar industry, you are already familiar about this word, yes or no? So which raw material and which type of industry we can get here? Yes, of course, it is none other, it is the agro-based industry. And also it is required that as a raw material, that is a sugar cane. So it is one of the agro-based industry, means agriculture-based industry we can consider, means it is a growing a crop. So it is none other than, there is a sugar cane, it was grown in an agriculture field. So what raw materials they can be used here, means there is none other sugar cane here. It is used as a raw material here. And almost all other factors also it is essential in order to establish there as a sugar industry in our state. What are the factors it is required here, means in order to grow sugar cane, it is required there as a climate condition. So in order to grow it, water supply it is required. In order to construct the industry, it is required there as a land, labor, capital, organization. These are the factors of production is must here, is all. And along with that, as about the production process, it was over. Then afterwards, in order to shift from one place to another, transport facility it is required. Along with that, the communication it is required. Nowadays everything it will be done in a machine. So for that reason, as about a power supply it is required. In order to run a machine, power supply is required. And even along with that, as about a market facilities and government policies. So these all matter important thing or important factors. It is essential in order to grow or in order to bring or in order to establish there as a sugar industry. So these all we can consider it as, it is a factors. It is essential for it also we can consider. And even though we have to know about another one most important thing. When as about the sugar industry it was started. As a person, Sir Francis Bacon. Writing book. What he told here is, in the early part of the 19th century, as itself as the sugar it was produced there. That is in Padali. It comes in a Srirangapatnam. And also even in a Chikballapur district. So what he told here is, which year it will be come here is, it is another 1847. So what he told or what he was explained here is, he explained in his written work, what he told here is, in the early part of the 19th century itself, as a sugar it was produced in a Padali, that is in Srirangapatna and also even in a Chikballapur district in the year 1847. And even though it was won the award, that is in a London exhibition also. Means whenever they are growing up things, then afterwards they will bring to a exhibition. So there also it was getting there as a award or about a prize we can consider. So it was won the prize in a London exhibition. And also which one is we can consider called as the first sugar industry or sugar mill, means that is a Mysore sugar mill. It was established in the year 1933, that is in Mandya. So which one is the first sugar industry or a sugar mill means? It is another. That is the Mysore sugar mill. It was established in the year 1933. That is a Mandya district. Clear now. And even along with that, from 1933 to till 1951, it is having only one over the sugar mill. It was there in our Karnataka. But at present, we can see there as nearly 47 sugar mill we can see in our Karnataka here. And it was constructed across the river. That is in a catchment area we can consider. It is in a Kaveri, Krishna and Tungabhadra river basin or about a river side as about these all industry it was constructed here. Clear no? So I hope you are understanding. And along with that, many other industries, the number of the industries we can see there in a Bagalkote and also Belgaum district also. And even along with that, many other places also it was having there as a sugar mill or sugar industries. They are Mandya, Mysore, Bidar, Bijapur, Bagalkote and about Davangere. Like this, there are many other places it was having there as a, at present also we can see there as a sugar mill and sugar industries also in our Karnataka. Clear? And along with that, it was having there as a two important byproduct it was having there. Two important byproduct it was having there. There is a molasses and bagasse. Molasses and bagasse. Even as about the molasses, it is a liquid in a quantity or a liquid item we can consider it was a utilizing for the production of alcohol. And about a bagasse, it is a crushed stem we can consider. After take out that juice from that sugar cane, as about a crushed stem, it will be left. No, it was a utilizing for the production of a paper industry. So both the byproduct also as about a waste part we can consider. It was also utilizing for other purpose as about a molasses. It was utilizing in the production of a alcoholic drink. And about a bagasse, it was utilizing in a paper industries. As about a waste part or about a crushed stem, after removing the juice from that sugar cane, it was utilizing for a paper industry as a raw material here. Clear? No? So these are the important things or about information about a sugar industry. So I hope you are understanding. It is one of the large scale industry we can consider. Large scale industry. It is one of the agro based industry. And sugar cane as it was utilizing as a raw material. And other factors also it is essential for in order to establish there as a sugar industry in our country or about in our state also we can consider. And along with it as a person what he told in his written work. And also along with it we learn there as a where as about a first sugar mill it was constructed. And which year from there to 51 how many industries were there. At present how many industries we are having in our Karnataka. That also we learn there. And along with it we learn there as a two important byproducts. It is a molasses and a bagasse. For this one also it was utilizing for a other purpose also we just now we learn there. So no. So I hope you are understanding clearly about the sugar industry. Now let's go for another one, that is a paper industry. Paper industry. Yes, it is one of the important forest based industry we can consider. Forest based industry. And it is one of the important industry in a world market or about a modern world we can consider. Because whatever we have to do, it is in a written way or in a written document we require here. In order to write something, we require there as a paper here, is or no? For it was for that purpose, as a vote of this industry, we can consider as a, it was a gain a name and fame in a modern world, we can consider. And it was a required for a writing purpose, printing purpose, newspaper purpose, and as a propagation of a religion matter, also it is required here. And earlier they are using that as a vote of bamboo and other trees as for in order to bring or in order to establish this paper industry as a raw materials here. But now at present we can see that as a shortage of, means it is having there, but as about the deforestation, it is strictly, it was prohibited, we can consider by a government. For that reason, in the, means in the lack of that tree matter, or a lack of cutting a trees here, even we are using there as other raw materials here. What are they here means, as about grass, as about the straw of paddy and wheat, and also about cotton lens, and about which one, wood pulp, and also bagasse, just so we learn that as it was utilizing in a paper industry. So these all raw materials, it was utilizing in the absence of these three, we can consider. Means instead of a tree matter, they are using that as these all raw materials as a raw materials, it was utilizing for a paper industry here. Clear? No? I hope you are understanding about what type of industry and what we can utilize earlier, and also what we are utilizing in the absence of that, also we learned just now. So, and even though as about the first paper mill, where we can see here is in a Bhadravati, that is a Mysore paper mill. It is the first paper mill. There is another Mysore paper mill. It was established in Bhadravati in the year 1936. Why it was constructed, or why it was constructed in a Bhadravati here means, it is because there it was having there as a dense forest, that is in a Chikmagalur district and also a Shivamogga district. So they can be utilized there as a trees in order to establish or in order to bring a development in a paper industry. And even along with that, later a private industry or a private company also given there as a priority to establish, that is a with West Coast paper mill, it was constructed or it was established in a Dandeli. Here also they are using there as a trees, that is from a nearby forest area, and also water from there as a Kali, and also electricity supply, it was supplied from a Jog Falls. So like this that they are utilizing here, and even along with that other industries, so other paper mills are other paper mills are, they are none other than Nagarjun Sagar, Krishnath Sagar, Mundugud, Yadgiri, Bangalore, Satyagaon, etc. So these are the other paper mills we can see in our Karnataka, that is another Nagarjun Sagar, Krishna Sagar, Mundugud, Yadgiri, Bangalore and Satyagaon. Like this are many other mills also we can see in our Karnataka. Even as about Karnataka, it was standing there as a fourth in a position. In our sugar industry, it was standing there as a third in a position, children. But about the paper mill or about paper industry, Karnataka, it was standing there as a fourth in a position here. So these are the important things are there about the paper industry. So I hope you are understanding, it is one of the forest based industry, and here it was utilizing there as a various raw materials, it is required, whatever we learn there as a which one factors or about the raw materials, what they are using instead of our trees, as we just now learned earlier, bamboo, and about other trees they are using. Now it was not, we should not utilize that one, we should not cut a tree, yes or no? In the absence or in addition of this, they are utilizing there as another thing as a raw materials also we just will learn along with that which one is we can call it as in Karnataka as the first paper mill that is a Mysore paper mill it was established in Bhadravati in the year 1936 and even though later afterwards private company also got a priority here they started there as a west coast paper mill that is in Dandeli even why it was started there as about in Bhadravati here means as about the dense forest we can see in Chikmagalur district and as a Shivamogga district and here they are using there as a nearby forest as a water trees they are using and a river from water from that Kali and also about the electricity supply it was from there as Joga so we learn there is other and even afterwards we learn there is one of the other mills also we just now we learn and which position also it was again by Karnataka in India also we just now learned about a paper industry hope you are understanding clearly there so now let's go for another one that is a cement industry industry it is one of the most important industry we can consider in a modern world we can consider why because it is required for a various purpose like a construction purpose for that reason only just now I told that as about due to the urbanization and also industrialization as about the cement industry it was played a very important role in order to establish or in order to bring there as a development to a nation also we learn that why it is required here means it is required for a construction purpose as in regarding there as a house or about a public building or about a dams or about a constructing a roads railways bridges etc for this all matter it is required here is or no and even along with that we learn there as about the limestone it is essential for a cement industry in our Karnataka and also even it was abundant or it is a rich and abundant in a Karnataka also and along with that in addition to this it was required there as a the gypsum and also about a bauxite these are also it was available in our Karnataka but only a coal it should be imported from a other state and remaining all we are having there as abundant key only coal it is there in a scarcity or in a shortage we can consider for that reason we are importing it from a other state and also remaining it will be having there clear no and it is also required there as a various factors what are the factors it is required means it is none other as about the raw materials just now we learned that and along with that the market or about the transport and communication and about the land labor capital organization power supply it is required there and transport facility is required market facility is required public policies also required here so these are important things are it is required here clear no and along with that as about the first sugar sorry cement industry it was started in Bhadravati that is in the year 1939 that is the first cement industry it was started or it was established in Bhadravati in the year 1939 and even as about the other side also it was established there is Amasandra that is in Tumkur district and Bagalkot and also about Ashabad that is in Gulbarga district and along with that many other centers also we can see there is other centers they are none other than Wadi and about Kanchipuram and so the center we can consider then they are Wadi Kanchipuram Ettigehalli Lokapuram etc so these are we can consider as these are the other centers of the cement industry only 8% of cement it was produced in our Karnataka in all over India we can consider so I hope you are understanding about what is that a cement industry first of all we learned that as due to the urbanization and also industrialization it was played a very important role for the establishment of our cement industry in our Karnataka why it is required here means so for various purpose like construction purpose regarding the construction of a house, construction of public building, roads, railways, bridge, canal, etc. These all purpose it is required here. And what are the raw materials it is required also? We just now we learn limestone it is required, gypsum is required, and about bauxite is required. Only a coal it is there in the scarcity. So we have to be imported from other state, and also where and all we can see that as a the cement industry is first it was established in Bhadravati, that is in the year 1939, and a little afterwards other industries also it was came, that is in Amasandra, that is in Tumkur district, Bagalkote, and also even about Shabad, that is in Gulbarga district also we just now we learn there, and along with it we learn there as a the centers where and all we can see here means Wadi, Kanjipuram, Idigalli, and Lokapuram, like this type, many other places also we can see about this type of industries. And the remaining part as about information technology regarding that, as it was also playing a very important role, children. But this topic it was a drop from your lesson, so I'll drop that apart. And also here this lesson it was comes to be at end here. So I hope you are understanding about the industries of Karnataka, how it was playing an important role in the development of India here. Clear? No? So here this lesson comes to an end, and in the next class we are learning a new lesson. Till then, take care. Thank you.